Okay, so we can start. So the webinar topic is application of BIM in AEC industry. So the basic idea of this webinar is to give an introduction about BIM and what are the different applications in this industry. So since it is not included in BTech curriculum, so many students are not aware about this BIM. And what are the opportunities once we get the knowledge about BIM? So these things are not covered in the BTech curriculum. So we thought like we will give an idea about BIM. So here, the students who are studying in diploma level or who are studying in BTech civil engineering and even the other field also can attend the session. And even the whoever is working in this AEC industry with partial or knowledge also can attend the session. Okay, so we can get started. So this would be the agenda of today's session. So we'll start with the introduction to BIM. So there we'll cover all the basics, like what is BIM, what are the different dimensions of BIM, and what is BIM maturity and level of development. So these are the terminologies commonly used in BIM industry. So once you all get to know about the basics about BIM, so then we'll start with BIM process. So there I'll cover the all life cycle of entire BIM process and what are the different softwares used and what to be the roles and responsibilities of each individual who are part of this BIM process. And what are the current trends and which all countries are adopted BIM and what is the future scope in India and even in abroad. And I'll explain the different application to life cycle also and the benefits of BIM. So this would be the agenda. So we can start with what is BIM. So BIM basically stands for Building Information Modeling. So many people believe that it's a software, but it's not a software, it's a tool, and there are n number of softwares under this tool. Okay, so it's basically a process supported by various tools and technologies. And so we can digitally represent the complete physical and functional characteristic of a building, not only the building, so we can show the characteristics of built asset. Okay, so I will explain that in very detailed way. So building information modeling. So in this B stands for building. So many believe that this B basically is building. Some believe that it's a commercial building. It's not like that. So it's all the everything in the built environment that includes cities, railways, highways, bridges, and even infrastructure and even landscape. Everything is coming under this building that day. Then comes information. So basically there are three different types of information is included in a BIM model. So that is graphical data, non-graphical data, and the documentation. So the graphical data means the visual information. So whatever we can see visually. So for example, we can take a cube or cuboid. So if we take a cube, so we can see the size. And so of course the shape we can know. And if some finishes are there, we can see the finisher. So these are called the graphical data. So there we have the spatial relationship. And even the geometric information will be there and the visual representation that is size, shape and finishes. And then defined by all these things are defined by level of development. So this level of development, I will be explaining this in the upcoming slides. Okay, so then comes non-graphical data. So non-graphical data means the parametric information. So if we take a building, so we can see many things visually. And if we take a building, so there are many elements inside that building, right? For example, we have doors, we have windows, and even bricks and the masonry walls, different types of walls are there. then flooring. So all these things are there. So there, for everything, we have different information in that. If we are, so for example, we can take a door. So definitely we can see the length, breadth and thickness, everything we can see. So that is the graphical data. So, but we need to know the parametric information also. That is, who is the manufacturer of door and the cost of that particular door. So all these things are coming under non-graphical data. Then comes the documentation. So when, if you wanted to construct something, if you wanted to construct a flat or anything, so there are different informations, right? Models will be there, schedules will be there, estimate will be there, and even the contract drawings will be there, and even other construction documents will be there. So these things can be shared in a common platform. So these things can be shared in different platforms. So basically, with the help of BIM, so we use a common platform to share the information. It's because there are different stakeholders involved in this in a particular process. So it is easy if we have a common source of common source to get the information. So that comes in the information part. So there we have the documentation. So there we have CDE. So there, so for example, there we can share all the relevant information related to a particular project. So in that, one example is Autodesk 360. So most of the companies are using this Autodesk 360. So there are Trimble Connect and even other platforms are also there. So mostly many companies are using this Autodesk 360 only. And many people believe that. So if we see a 3D model, that is a BIM model. It's not like that. If we have a 3D model with all the parametric informations, like all the parametric information, then it is called a BIM model. If we have a model without any of these information, it's not a BIM model. So moving forward, so there are different dimensions of BIM. So 3D, 4D, 5D, 6D, and 7D. So 3D means only the basic 3D model. So there we have all the information like length, breadth, height, and like all the basic 3D information. So when the time is added to that is called 4D. So basically, there it's timeline. We can create the timeline. So within 2 months, or within 5 months, or within 2 year, or 1 year, how much we can complete. So those things we can get to know with a 4D model. Okay. So when we add cost to that is called 5D model. Okay. So with this, we can get to know at this particular stage how much money we are spending on that on a particular project. So we can know whether we are spending the money that we estimated, or we are spending overestimated. Those kind of things we can get to know with a BIM model. Then comes the sustainability, and so that is 6D. So nowadays, many are giving so much importance to sustainability because of this increasing carbon footprint and even other environmental factors. So many companies are constructing buildings with a lot of greeneries. When they are constructing a wall, so they are doing energy analysis. So these energy analysis and all we can do with this BIM softwares, like Revit, and even other softwares are also there to do the energy analysis. Okay. Then even before installing the light and even the other equipments, though they calculate the energy or that equipment is releasing, and even they calculate the carbon footprint. So these things are covered in the 6D. So then comes the 7D. Then the facility, when it facility management added to that is called 7D. So this is coming in the operational stage of a building. So once we hand over the model to the owner or the client, at that time, what we do is we So basically, in a construction company, basically in a BIM company, there'll be a facility management team. So what they usually do is they will collect all the information related to the all the trades and even the equipment. So there'll be a software to store all this information. So with one click, owner or the client will get all the information about that particular element. For example, if we have a light and if it's got damaged due to some reason, so we wanted to replace that particular light, and we'll have a model. So with the help of that model, we will just click that particular light and we'll get all the information like who is the manufacturer and what are the details about the beam, to whom we need to approach to replace that particular light. All these information will be there. And so this is what is there in the 7D. So levels of BIM maturity. So there are four levels, that is level 0, 1, 2, and 3. So level 0 is very basic level. So there we don't have BIM properly. So that is no collaboration between the teams. So basically the information is exchanged through paper. And here, if you see here, so for in the case of level 0, the CAD is involved. So with the help of CAD, we can draw the only the lines and text, right? So we won't be able to get the parametric information here. We won't be able to see the exact shape and all. So everything is in 2D. So there, that's why it's called lack of BIM. And since it's shared with the paper, and so there is no common platform to share the information, so that's why it's called no collaboration, and it's called lack of BIM. So then comes level 1. So there partially CAD is involved and even the BIM is involved, and there we have models and objects. But the thing is, so there is collaboration is involved introduced with the help of different platform which I mentioned earlier, but there is no complete collaboration. So there is no single source to share the information. So then comes the level 2. So there the complete BIM. So there is a platform to share the information. So that is so for platform like BIM, Autodesk 360 or other platforms are there. So there what we can do is, if n number of people are there for a particular project, what all these people can get information from this particular platform. For example, for constructing a flat, so there will be electrical engineers, mechanical engineers, civil engineers, and even the architects and even the contractors. All these people are there. So architects, they'll be creating the drawings, and even the civil engineers, they will also be generating the drawings. They will be doing the design and all. So what they will do is they will share all the information in this BIM Autodesk document management folder. So from that particular folder, who even the other people. So one, for example, if I'm a civil engineer, what I will do is I will complete the design, and even I'll generate some shop drawings. I will store that in the particular folder. Even the same will do same draw. So those drawings can be used by this electrical engineers and even the contractors and even the mechanical engineers. So for no one need to approach anyone independent. Go and approach architect. No need to go and approach a civil engineer. So there is a platform to collect all the information. So we are in a transition stage from level 1 to level 3. So even level 2 is also not completely achieved. Okay, so level 3 is iBIM. So there the complete and total collaboration is there in the case of planning, construction, and even the operational life cycle of a building. Then comes the level of development or level of detail. So earlier it was called level of detail. Now it's called level of development. So its level of development is divided like this: LOD 100, LOD 200, 300, 350, 400, and 500. And the basically LOD means it's an industry-driven standard, and it shows the 3D geometry of a building. It shows the 3D geometry of a building and how can we achieve this 3D geometry at different stages. For example, at the pre-design stage, how it will look like, and the schematic design stage, design development stage, and the construction documentation stage, and even at the construction stage and as-built stage. So with the help of LOD, we can see at each stage how our building will look like. Okay, so let's start with LOD 100, that is pre-design. So at this stage, we'll have only the very basic information, and only the conceptual model creation is possible at this stage. And of course, we have this area, height, volume, location, and orientation. All these will be defined at this particular stage. At this LOD 200, that is the schematic design stage. At this, so all the elements will be modeled with very approximate quantities, shape, size, location, and even orientation. And also the non-graphical information, that is cost, manufacturer details, all these will be attached. And at LOD 300, so we need to do the accurate modeling, and even we need to create shop drawings with the specific assemblies, precise quantity, size, shape, location, and even the orientation. So of course, here also non-graphical information is attached. So then comes LOD 350, that is construction documentation stage. So here at this stage, the model detail and the element should be very precise, and it should have all the elements will have should have the graphical and the written definition should be there. So this is the one most of the BIM companies ask for, and almost all the construction firms, they will ask for BIM 36 LOD 350 model. So when we do a meeting with the client, so first we need to finalize which level of detail we need to share. So mostly they will ask for LOD 350, and some of them ask for LOD 300. So no one will ask for LOD 100 or 200. So if they ask for LOD 100 or 200, so there is no meaning in implementing BIM for that particular project. So then comes the construction stage. So here the thing is all the elements should be modeled as specific assemblies. So mostly the steel companies, so they usually go with this LOD 400, and what they usually do is they create each assemblies, specific assemblies at this at their factories, and they go and install everything at the site. So almost all the steel manufacturers, so steel companies, they are going with LOD 400. And LOD 500 is like everything is modeled as a constructed assemblies. And so what we can do is, so they can what they can do is they can create everything at a factory, and they can go and install at the site. So many companies like Shurports, what they are doing is they create the bathroom units and all at their factory. So even they add mirror and even the flooring and even WCs and even other pipes, shower, everything they will add at their factory, and they will transport that, and they will fix that at the site. So these are mainly done in foreign countries because they don't have enough time for the construction. So basically, because of this climatic conditions over there, they won't have enough time for the construction. So they will go with this prefabrication, and even they will construct the building with constructed assembly so that they can reduce the time. So this is just an overview, like what is LOD 100, 200, 300. So LOD 100, as I mentioned earlier, it's a generic representation of elements. It conveys only the basic idea, so not the exact shape, orientation and all. So then 200 is the approximate representation of elements and gives only the rough idea about the elements or the facility. Then LOD 300, so there the specific geometric size of the element, orientation, location, quantity, all these should be there. And LOD 350, as I mentioned, so almost all the construction firms ask for LOD 350, so there precise information will be there. And then LOD 400, all the sufficient information for fabrication of elements. So here it's elements. So here what is it? The complete unit is constructing. LOD 500 shows the operational geometry of the component with the varied information like manufacturer details, date, part, and the model number, etc. will be there. Okay, so with this we covered the very basics about BIM. So now we can start with the life cycle of BIM process. So as you can see here, so this is the entire life cycle. So one start with programming, then conceptual design, then comes the detailed design, then analysis, documentation, prefabrication, then construction will happen, then construction of logistics. So this is the life cycle. So the basically BIM, it's a process to create and manage information of the construction project in the entire life cycle. So it's like so we can store all the information and we can do all the things from scratch. So for this is a collaborative process, and many stakeholders are involved. So basically the engineers, as I mentioned earlier, so different engineers from different field, and even architect contractors, and even AEC professionals, and many are involved in this. So for two many are involved in this in the BIM process, and we have a common data environment to share all the information. So I will we can divide this entire process into five parts. So that is pre-design, design, pre-construction, construction, and then comes the operational use. So I'll explain what will happen in the pre-design stage. So in the pre-design stage, basically the scanning will happen. So if we wanted to renovate something, or if we wanted to add extend a building, so for that case, what basically do is with there'll be a team called Reality Capture. So they capture all the information and what they in the pre-design stage. So they capture all the information, and with the help of different softwares, so what they do is they capture those information. They will convert it as a design, the model. Okay, so they will convert that to a 3D model. So once they complete the 3D model, so then the detailed design will happen. So there different structural engineers and even the others will also involve at this stage. Then once the design and all completed, so then comes the analysis and documentation happen. So that is pre-construction stage, and then comes at the construction stage. So at that construction stage, what will happen is all the information will transfer from model to model to a prototype. So whatever details we added in the model, so we will transfer everything at the construction site. So at this stage, what we need to do is we need to coordinate all the trade models. So all the trade models, and we need to resolve all the clashes in the building. So for example, so if I wanted to build a office building, so in the office building, so we have mechanical ducts and all, and even the plumbing system is also there, the fire is also there, and the architectural different architectural walls will be there, the structural columns, structural beams, everything will be there. So all these things are done by different engineers. So they are not aware about what is done by other team. So what they basically do is, so they do a coordination of so once they complete everything and once they share all this information in the common data environment, so BIM coordinator will collect all these models, and he or she will combine everything as a single model, and they will run the clash test, and they will check any of these trades models is clashing with any of these members. If they are clashing with any of these members, what they will do is, if a structural column is clashing with the mechanical duct, so what they can do, they will do is they will inform the mechanical engineer, and they will tell them to relocate it. So because we can't change the location of the structural column, so what they want the mechanical engineer will do is they will change the location of this particular duct. So like this way, so the BIM coordinator, they will run n number of clash tests, and they will create a clash-free model, and that will happen before the construction. So once we get a clash-free model, what we do, what basically we need to do is we need to transfer all this information from this model to the site. Okay, so these are the basic things involved in a BIM process. Then comes the operational and maintenance, and at this stage, the facility management team is involved. So there, what they mainly do is they store and maintain and or maintain all the information related to the building. So they are there. The main process comes is building information support for renovation and termination will be happen at this particular stage, and data platform for continuous monitoring and predictive maintenance. All these things happen at the operation and maintenance stage. So for this entire process, so different people are involved. They are architects, engineers, quantity surveyors, and the project managers are also there, and even contractors and even clients are also there. So the basic function, like basic task they are completing is, like for an architect, they need to design everything, and they need to create the construction documents, and for engineers, they should create performance analysis, they should create the MEP models and even the structural and all the documentation, everything. So quantity surveyors, they need to do the material takeoff, cost analysis, those things need to do. And the project managers, so they need to do all the main issues reporting and the planning and everything. Then the contractors, they will also the part of clash detection and even the work scheduling, prototyping, all these things. Then the clients, so they'll be part of this facility management, and of course for the brief analysis of this entire process. So this is all about BIM process. So these are the some of the softwares used for BIM. So for modeling and rendering. So these are the some of the softwares like Lumion, Revit, 3ds Max, SketchUp. And for visualization, is we have 4D and visualization, the Zingro, Navisworks, Primavera. So for collaboration, so this one I already mentioned earlier, BIM 360 Glue, BIM 360 Document Management, then the Trimble Connect, Bentley Connect, Viewpoint Collaboration, these things. Then for the BIM software planning and construction management, so this Syncro Pro, Navisworks, Navigator. So I'll just tell which are the common softwares used in India. So Revit, 3ds Max. So these are the very commonly used in India for 3D model creation. So if you have, if you learn Revit or 3ds Max or SketchUp, so you can start your career in this BIM field as a modeler. So of course, for rendering, Lumion is a best software for the rendering. And for 4D model creation, so mostly Navisworks, we can use. And for collaboration, so for sharing the documents, so we can use BIM 360 Document Management to create a merge model and for clash detection and all. So we can create a merge model using BIM 360 Glue. And here also the planning and so for Vico is there and Syncro Pro is also there. So these are the most commonly used planning and construction softwares. Then roles and responsibility. So these are the here I listed the roles and responsibilities of each BIM engineer, BIM coordinator, and BIM modeler. You can read these ones. So first I will start with BIM modeler. So people who completed BTech or diploma or even the MTech, they can start their career as a BIM modeler. So in some companies it's called project engineer, in some companies it's BIM engineer. So mostly they start their career with a career as BIM modeler if they have basic knowledge of this Revit or 3ds Max, SketchUp, or any of these modeling software. Okay, so once we join as a BIM modeler, so the main responsibilities of we need to do is like the main responsibilities are we need to create a 3D model of different disciplines. So different disciplines means like architectural model we need to create, and like a structural model and mechanical, electrical, plumbing. So one can't do all these modeling because there'll be different teams in BIM companies. So there'll be a particular team for the architectural modeling, there'll be a particular team for structural modeling, and there'll be a team for the concrete modeling, and there'll be a team for MEP modeling. So they need to create a model, and even the 2D drawings they need to create, and also they need to follow the BIM execution plan properly. They need to check whether all the models are created as per the standard mentioned in the BIM execution plan, and of course they need to collaborate and even coordinate with the other discipline modelers also. If I am doing the architectural modeling, so I need to communicate with the structural team. So there'll be some tasks like, so that I might have architectural column and they might have structural column. So to avoid the repetition of work, so we need to communicate with these people, and we need to avoid the repetition of the work. So once we complete 2 3 years as BIM modeler, then I'll get promoted to BIM coordinator. And I'll, so if we are working as a BIM modeler, so the basic CTC they will get is, so it's based on if the based on our degree. So if we have a BTEC, and if I have BTEC, and if I know very basics about or any of these modeling softwares, so they will get a CTC around 4.5 to 5.5. Okay. So if a person who is having MTech and they know all these softwares, so they might get a CTC around 6 to 7 when they start their career as a BIM modeler. And once they get promoted as a BIM coordinator, so of course their CTC will increase. So there the basic responsibility is to coordinate with all the discipline modelers. And I already mentioned about this BIM coordinator earlier. They need to get all the models. So they need to get architectural, structural, MEP, and all these models, and they need to create a merge model, and they need to run a class test. And if any clashes are there, they need to share the information with these modelers, and they need to tell what are the clashes and how to relocate the duct or the plumbing unit or all these things they need to share. And of course they need to follow the BIM execution plan, and they need to check whether all the BIM data, like BIM related information, is following, or all these details mentioned in the BIM execution plan is followed properly. All these things they should check. Then comes the BIM manager. So then people will, so whoever completed a few years as a BIM coordinator, of course they will get promoted as a BIM manager, and they'll get a CTC around 12, 12 to it might vary. So they can start their career with 12, CTC 12. Okay. Okay, so there the basic responsibility is they need to create a BIM execution plan, and they need to tell like what are the requirement for each model. So for if they will share the information with the architect. So in their particular model, what all information should be there, and even the structural, like structural team. So they will tell like what all information should be there. So all these things will be there in the BIM execution plan. And so all the process should be followed properly, and all these things will be checked by a BIM manager. Okay. So BIM, then comes the BIM adoption, evolution, and growth. And here, as you can see, like many countries are already implemented BIM. So in some countries, it's mandatory to have a BIM model before the construction. So, so countries like UK, even United States, all these in these countries. So we need to submit a BIM model before construction. So we need to get approval from government, and then only they will allow to construct something, or even a small structure also. For constructing you for a small structure also, then they need to get the BIM approval. So here you can see, you can go through here, like in Canada, it's already in the implementation stage. So these are the all the informations, like in China. So strong government support is there. So these things, like in Qatar, it's in 2017 it's planned to implement, and even in Dubai. So in all Middle East countries, it's already implemented. And we are so in India, so we are getting a lot of projects from abroad. So many BIM companies, mostly they are getting projects from abroad only. So only few construction companies in India only adopted BIM, and they adopted BIM and they completed the project with the help of BIM. So this is the adoption rate. So if you see in US, it's coming around 79, and in Canada, it's coming around 78. So with UK, Australia, like and even China, so you can see the adoption rate. So it's really huge. So with this, you might have like how much job opportunities are there in different countries. If we complete a course in this area, or like if you get a basic knowledge about BIM, or if you start a career in this field, so there are different opportunities in abroad. And of course, we will get different in the upcoming years in India also, we'll get different opportunities in this field, because now L&T and even other companies are also implementing BIM in Indian projects as well. Okay, so if you open LinkedIn or any other job hunting platform, you can see a number of opportunities in this field. So in India, so these are the few projects like Amritsar, personal rapid transit is completed with a BIM scope of scheduling, planning, designing, and construction. And in Bangalore Airport also, this BIM scope is Autodesk 360 for design and planning. And of course, for Nagpur Metro, so BIM scope is 5D, and Delhi Metro, so underground track construction. So if you see here, so for different scope, different, so it's not mandatory that we need to have a only one scope. So there are different scope, and for these different scope only, they adopted BIM. So this Bangalore airport terminal, so this is done by L&T. So this is done by one of the BIM company. So even Chennai Metro is also implemented BIM. So even in the nearby future, we'll get a lot of Indian projects. So, but now in many MNCs, so we are people are, like in MNCs, there are a lot of projects from abroad. So if you start a career, and if you start a career in this field, so definitely it's booming in India. So definitely you can, in few years, you can also become a BIM manager or BIM coordinator in the upcoming years. So the current trends in BIM, so I will explain different application through life cycle. So I already explained the life cycle. So what are the different applications? So in the pre-construction stage, so here site logistics and laser scanning. So this one I explained. Then augmented reality and virtual reality. Then photogrammetry. So these things are happened at the pre-construction stage. So laser scanning I already explained. We capture all the information at the site, then we convert it as a design. So here AI-based design tools are there, 4D sequencing and the 5D model-based estimation. So 4D sequencing, we have a software called Navisworks, then 5D model-based estimation. So LCA, sustainability studies. So all these things are happening at the design stage. Then design documentation, digital document management. Then coordination and issue resolution, all these things. So there'll be different people involved in this all these different applications. So there'll be a team for 4D sequencing, there'll be a team for 5D model-based estimation, there'll be a team for LZA, and there'll be a team for document management, there'll be a team for design coordination. So you can see like how many people are involved in this BIM. So there'll be a team for laser scanning, and so there'll be a team who be creating augmented reality and virtual reality models. So all these things are there. And then for the construction, so again, AR is there so that with the help of AR, we can reduce the accidents at the site and, of course, prefabrications. So with all the information, so we can store all the information in a model. So with all these information, what we can do is we can transfer that information to a prefabrication unit. So there'll be robotic arm. So like there'll be people who will be doing the prefabrication. So they will construct everything at the factory itself. So we can reduce the time. So virtual mock-up is basically to create the building joints, and also we can see how many layers are there. Just like so for a wall, if you explode a wall, we explode a corner of a wall, there'll be waterproofing and there'll be plastering. So all these information can be captured through virtual mock-up. So then, of course, the model-based coordination. So this I explained earlier. Then trade modeling and shop drawing creation. Then the collaborative cloud platforms and even the workflows. So these things are at the construction stage. And at the turnover, the facility management, and then the processing BIM, then the integration of BAS system, and even as-built models. So all these are at the turnover stage. Then what are the benefits? So these are the major benefits. So we can, of course, we can reduce the errors. So for many construction site, what is usually happen is one, they will create a superstructure, and once the plumbing unit or once the mechanical unit, they come to site and they will find that, okay, so there is a wall, so and it will clash with our deck. So all these things they will see only after the construction in usual scenario. So scenario in India, like the usual scenario what we see at the site, right? So these things will create loss of many these things will create many losses, and even project will end up in a lot of low we will go with the overestimation, like we need to spend a lot of money. So all these things will happen. So what with the help of BIM, we can reduce the errors and even the omissions by creating a merge model and resolving all the clashes prior to the construction. So even we can check the constructability issues, whether the beam is at so whether the beam is at the proper location, whether the slab is at, so all these things we can see before the construction. So here we can reduce the rework and reduce the construction cost, reduce project duration, and even we can reduce the claims. All these things is a major benefits, and other things are there, like it's very user friendly, and it's easy to share the information, and even the transparency and detail visualization. So before construction, before completing a structure, the owner or the client, they can see how their building will look like, look at the after the construction. All these things they can see, then better, like we can prefabricate the elements and we can press calculate how much amount of work is there, and we have more possibility to innovate, and we can, of course, we can avoid errors. So these are the main things. But in the initial cost of this BIM implementation is really high. So because to buy the software and to create a 3D model, the time, so all these things are really high. So but if we spend that much amount in the beginning of a project, we will, of course, we will be able to reduce the construction cost, and we'll be able to finish our project on time. Okay, so that's the main reason in India. So many construction companies are not adopting BIM because of this initial cost. Okay, so that is all about BIM.
ഹലോ
Yeah.
അഖില, നമുക്ക് കാര്യമായ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ഒരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആണ് മെയിൻ ആയിട്ട് വന്നിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഈസ് ബിം കോഴ്സ് ഓൺലി ഫോർ സിവിൽ എഞ്ചിനീയേഴ്സ് ഓർ ഓൾസോ ഫോർ ആർക്കിടെക്ട്സ് എന്നാണ് ഒരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ വന്നിരിക്കുന്നത്.
Okay, so BIM means not only for civil engineers, even mainly in BIM companies, there are architects, there are civil engineers, there are electrical engineers, mechanical engineers, and in all these engineering domains are there. It's not only for civil engineers.
ഓക്കെ, വേറെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ഒന്നും വന്നിട്ടില്ല. ഇനി എന്തെങ്കിലും ഡൗട്ട്സോ കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ. ഓ, വൺ വൺ സെക്കൻഡ്, ഒരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ കൂടി വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. സ്പെഷ്യലൈസേഷൻ ഇൻ ബിം ഓർ സ്പെഷ്യലൈസേഷൻ ഇൻ 3D ഡിസൈൻ ആൻഡ് വിഷ്വലൈസേഷൻ, വിച്ച് വൺ ഈസ് ഗുഡ് ടു ബിൽഡ് എ കരിയർ ഫോർ എ സിവിൽ സ്റ്റുഡൻറ്റ്?
Sorry, can you repeat the question in
സ്പെഷ്യലൈസേഷൻ
name?
ഇൻ ബിം ഓർ സ്പെഷ്യലൈസേഷൻ ഇൻ 3D ഡിസൈൻ ആൻഡ് വിഷ്വലൈസേഷൻ, വിച്ച് വൺ ഈസ് ഗുഡ് ടു ബിൽഡ് എ കരിയർ ഫോർ എ സിവിൽ എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് സ്റ്റുഡൻറ്റ്
So
എന്നാണ്
yeah,
ചോദിച്ചത്.
with this both you can start a career in this BIM field. So it's not, so actually I'm a civil engineer. After that I did masters in construction management. So there only there I did a course, only one subject that is related to BIM, and then I choose my career in the BIM field. So it's not mandatory we need to take a degree completely related to BIM. So if it's a small part also, then it's okay. So but we need to start our career as BIM engineer or BIM modeler or the project engineer. So we need to start like that.
ഓക്കെ, വേറൊരു ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് ഡിഫിക്കൾട്ട് ഫോർ സം വൺ ടു ലേൺ ഓട്ടോ ക്യാഡ് ഹു ഈസ് നോട്ട് ദാറ്റ് മച്ച് ഗുഡ് അറ്റ് ഡ്രോയിങ്?
AutoCAD is, no, AutoCAD is not that difficult. It's already covered, covering in the BTEC curriculum. It's really easy to learn CAD, and of course it's easy to learn Revit also. And one thing, it's not mandatory to know AutoCAD to start a career in this field. So because I am working in this field and I am not using AutoCAD that much.
Okay, fine. Can student learn AutoCAD during second year?
I think it's in third year of BTEC.
Okay,
yeah,
fine.
So maybe it's question is like, so whoever is doing the second year of BTEC, yeah, of course they can do, and like, so maybe it's like they can do a course online, or like they can go some CAD center, or like they can learn. Yeah, so of course they can learn.
Okay, fine. What is the main software to be studied to become a BIM modeler?
So as I mentioned earlier, so in India, the most of the construction companies are using Revit. So it's good that if you learn all the basics about Revit, so that so you will be able to learn all the other softwares very easily.
Okay. സോ വേറെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ഒന്നുമില്ല. ഇനിയിപ്പോൾ രണ്ട് മൂന്ന് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. അപ്പോൾ നമുക്കിനി ഒരു ചെറിയൊരു സെഷനും കൂടി ബാക്കിയുണ്ട്. അപ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾ ചോദിക്കുന്ന ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ഈ ചാറ്റ് ബോക്സിൽ വന്നിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു ട്രെയിനിങ് അണ്ടർസ്കോർ ടെക് അറ്റ് അസാപ് കേരള ഡോട്ട് GOV ഡോട്ട് ഇൻ എന്ന മെയിലിലേക്ക് നിങ്ങളുടെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് അയക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നമ്മളത് ആൻസർ ചെയ്യുന്നതായിരിക്കും. അപ്പോൾ താങ്ക് യു അഖില ഫോർ ഹാവിംഗ് ദിസ് സെഷൻ. It was a wonderful session. Thank you for taking your time to explain BIM and other software courses to our students.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, fine. Okay, ASAP Kerala launch ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്ന Autodesk BIM for Architecture Design Development എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ ഒരു കോഴ്സിനെ കുറിച്ച് നിങ്ങളോട് എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ചെയ്യാൻ വേണ്ടി BIM ITന്റെ One second. Okay. എന്ന കോഴ്സിനെ കുറിച്ച് നിങ്ങളോട് എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ചെയ്യാൻ വേണ്ടി എക്സിക്യൂട്ടീവ് ഡയറക്ടർ ഓഫ് BIM IT മിസ്റ്റർ വിജു ആന്റണി നമ്മുടെ കൂടെ ഉണ്ട്. സാർ,
can you hear me?
Yeah, okay.
My audio is good, right?
Yeah, good.
Please allow me to share the screen.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm now able to share that. You're seeing my screen, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So I would start with a simple presentation on what is the name of the course. Well, the title of the course is Autodesk BIM for Architecture, Engineering, and a Concession. So this title is the total program's title. And we have three modules. One is the first module is BIM for Architectural Design Development. Second one, BIM for Structural Design Development and Detailing. Third, BIM for Concession Management. So these are the three modules under that. So each module will be having 30 hours of training and 15 hours of project work. So when you join for this course, you are joining for a first module. And once that finish first module, then we go next module can be selected. So there are three modules like this. So having these three modules, we would able to cover the entire BIM program. So various BIM topics are given here. In the module one, you find the BIM concepts and definition. That is the first one. Then BIM based 3D sketching and conceptual design phase using Formit. So we are having a program called Autodesk Formit. So this is using for conceptual design, and this is the first step we are introducing in this. Then we move to Revit program. Revit for architectural modeling and concession document, site work, rendering and presentation, and we have project work. So in the first module, the first course is on BIM concepts and definition, Formit, Revit, and Revit with the Revit for modeling, concession document, site work, rendering, project work in a detailed way. So all can be learned this, like BTech civil engineering students, diploma civil engineering, diploma architecture, BR students, architectural interior design and architecture students can join on this, right? So module one is described in detail, right? Each syllabus details are given here. So in BIM concepts and definition, we are learning concept of BEP, BIM execution plan, what is the concept and principles of EIR, data exchange format, various definitions of BIM project deliverables. Then you heard today's presentation, no? She she was explaining about BIM levels. So we are going to learn BIM level of development, level of detail, BIM levels, BIM dimension, BIM fundamentals. All these concepts are learning in that. Then we move to the sketching and conceptual design using Formit. This is a very essential tool in that. So Formit software is engaging here, and you can see there are these are the tools we are covering in that. So then we move to the Revit program, and we cover Revit modeling part. So we start from the interface and how do we work with the project concept, configuration settings. All these are covering here. And next, we have a working with the modeling tools, and we go in detail on how we create the wall types, wall layers, adding material, because we want to take the data from that. You know, we have to take the information from this model. So all these are in detail we learn here. Then we go for doors and windows and how to make custom libraries for that. Then we go for a floor, false ceiling, interiors, curtain walls, and a stair type, and a roof working with the modeling place. So these are the tools covering for the modeling part. Then we move to the concession documentation, which are very important for your you know, submission drawings. So how to add dimensions, styles, adding text and all. So we can see this schedule, grouping, format. You know, schedules are using to extract information in a tabular way. So you can easily get, you know, wall schedule, doors and windows details like that. Then we have rooms and room boundary, like concepts like area calculations and all coming there. Then we will go for, you know, different documentation view. You heard about, you know, in LOD. So in the LOD development of the model, it is essential to have this detailed view. So we have the callout views, drafting views, detailing, different detailing techniques in that. So in this, we have covered with a printing and how to work with the various formats. Now, then we move to the site work. So site and topography, creating site with the various methods. And then we go for the perspective, camera setting, and creating sketchy view for a presentation. Then we have a walkthrough options available here. So related to site work, rendering, and presentation, we learn all this. So these are the contents of the first module. So like that, this is the first module. I explained like that there is a second module. In the second module, we go for a structural design. Structural design using the Revit platform. Then there is an element called robotic structural analysis. There is an analysis engine. So we have a detailing tools and analysis engine covering that. Then we go for the module 3. In the module 3, we have BIM implementation, process planning, and all. Then, you know, concession management software is employed here, like a 4D simulation presentation using Navisworks, quantification of BIM model using the Navisworks. Then, you know, there is an inference analysis using BIM 360 Glue. All these tools are employed. So these are the various solutions providing in this. So I'm from BIM IT, and we are the authorized partner of Autodesk, and we are providing this with the Autodesk software platform. So I'm just showing you a few more things here quickly. This will be one of the model we will be teaching you. So my whole course will be based on developing on this model. So you will be working on a real model. Actually, this is one of the real model. We have the structural model as well as the architectural model. So you will understand how to migrate from, how to link with the structural design and then how to work with it. Because most of my students are going to be civil engineering students. So these two modules, we will able to understand equally. So in the first level, we are learning this, you know, these are the detailed plan. We will cover all the tools using this platform. So my approach would be a workflow based approach. It's not a tool based. No, I'm going to teach you stair. No, no, it's not like that. We are going to work on stair in this project. So you will be learning what are the essential design information required and how do we learn the stair in the context of a project. Because we have a space issue, we have a height issue, we have the, you know, landing and the design issue. So we will learn stair tool based on a project. So that will be, you know, a real approach for understanding the Revit model, Revit tools for your project. Now we can, these are the different views prepared in that. This is first floor view, and this is rooftop, and we can find some exterior views here. So these are the models we have created in that. This model will be utilized for your learning. It's a very detailed one. So you can find the detail. There is a, you know, this is a curtain walls, you know, these curtain walls will be employed, and this will be doing that. This is the first stage of the model. I just showed you the detail without much interior and all. This is the skeleton of the model. We are just showing you that. Now, how I'm teaching you is using the online platform, and we have a course material here, and we give you the course material, and we can able to share that. So let me just take that. So this is the platform we have. So for example, this is the platform. We have an LMS platform, and we also have a app, mobile app. So we have this platform, so we can see the lessons on the left side. Each lesson is having, you know, details, notes and all, and some of the examples given here and the illustrations given here. And it's, some of them is including a video also. It's my own, our own video is included there. And when you go to the next lesson, you can find that its activity comes there. So you can just browse through this lesson. So each individual will get this course material access, and they will able to follow this. So these are the information, these are the course material style. I'll just open one more. This is about the stair tool. So we teach, you know, stair concepts and all, then how to work with the stair. So these are the lessons we cover, and then we take you to the project, and in the project, you will be covering that aspect. So we are just showing you some of the lessons plans here. Now, next thing, you know, you heard about some softwares employed. So I'll just show you BIM 360, what is it? Because most of the companies doesn't have a license. So we are a license users. So this is the fundamental BIM 360 environment. So account admin access here, and this is BIMIT's account admin access. And I can show you these are the various projects we have done. And I'll just, you know, share one of the element here. You can see that details here. So when you open this project, you can see the project admin aspects here. These are the various members enrolled here, various softwares, you know, utilizing here. I'll just go to document management, one of the, you know, common software using. So document management is the technology. It's all cloud based. You can just access like Gmail and all, you know, you're just browsing and accessing here. You can see on the right side, Vijuan is my name, and that is the access location. So these are the various, you know, project members sharing their, you know, contents, and they're sharing their details here. And some of the members are going to utilize the issue. Say, for example, I opened this. This is one of the output of the file, you know, just a simple model. I'm just showing you as an example. So these are the things we are learning in this program. You heard of what are the concepts and all. So I'm just showing you. So this drawing, you know, one of the architect firm shared, consultant shared the drawing. And, you know, some of the markups given here, you can find the marks up detail, but in this example, I'm showing you some of the issues raised by the reviewer. So you will be working as a reviewer, and the issues are raised and they are answered. All these details can be given here. Say, for example, I take this, you know, there is a drainage issue. Say, for example, this is taken here. So you can see the number here, and the drainage issue, what is the issue here? The detail of the issue is given, and you know, the location is given. It is under the T2, toilet number 2, then the description, and the drainage has some, you know, that issue has been fixed. So the question is here, now this guy is the owner. He has, you know, some design deficiency shown, and these are the information given to Sham Vern, one of the plumbing designer. So it is assigned to him, and he has answered that. You can see the activity happen here. So as a, you know, this process, you can see that, you know, this person has created an issue. That means he has raised a problem with the, you know, drainage issue. There is no drain, floor trap, you know, mentioned there. So drains are not mentioned. So that is not created. So it's created. No, this is in the mental issues. This is communicating, and you can track the document management aspects of that. So this is one example I just showed you. So similarly, we can have various aspects covering in this. So the model, you know, model can be, you know, this is my contribution that you can see various aspects are covered in this diagram. So this is actually a BIM 360 environment, and in that environment you find you know, the various outputs from the different consultants uploaded. So I'll just show you one of the 3D model, then I'll move to the next one. So the 3D model I'm just showing, so this is the same one, right? So 3D first, let's take this. So the Revit model, you can easily visualize in the in this platform. So this is just, this is not Revit, this is just the BIM 360. So you can able to, you know, control the, you know, control the model, view, visualize this in different aspects. You can have, you know, class checking, a lot of features. So we will be learning that in the program, right? So these are the softwares engaged, and finally, I have a simple, you know, a presentation, a simple video, how the BIM 360, how Revit, everything works together. So in that same aspects, we are teaching you. So let's have this view quickly. Voice may not be that good, but you can see that.
Every AEC project begins with an idea and a multidisciplinary team working with a collection of tools to bring that idea to life. Civil engineers start.
And there is a problem in the sharing of that. Second.
With a collection of tools to bring that idea to life. Civil engineers start by developing an existing conditions model at InfraWorks. Point cloud data from recap and GIS content, such as sewer and flood information, are added to enrich the model and enable the conceptual design of road and site layouts in the project's real-world context. Switching to building design, a concept is sketched for a health clinic in the site context using Format Pro. The massing is refined, details and materials are added. The impact of sun and shadows is studied. Solar analysis is performed. Insight is used to conduct whole building energy analysis and optimization. Back at InfraWorks, the conceptual models are evaluated within the site context. Next, detailed building design is performed in Revit. The form of mass is used to locate architectural elements. Dynamo is used to study alternative roof concepts through computational design. Structural and MEP engineers create models for engineering design, analysis, detailing, and documentation. The design disciplines link their Revit models to ensure the building design remains coordinated throughout the process. As the building design comes together, civil engineers develop the detailed site design in civil 3D, including parking lot layout, grading, and drainage networks. Using vehicle tracking, even vehicle movement can be simulated and analyzed. And in InfraWorks, a compelling visual is generated to improve understanding of the design. The next phase of the project is the design of a hospital. As before, the project moves from concept to completion with Format Pro and Revit, starting with architectural elements. Structural and MEP engineering disciplines join the project to create a highly detailed, coordinated building design. During pre-construction, design teams and contractors can perform 3D clash detection on the building and site models in Navisworks. Together, the team can identify interferences between steel framing and mechanical ducts in the building, as well as between site utility networks in the infrastructure design, enabling resolution of any issues between design intent, constructability, and fabrication before construction even begins. Finally, the team can also conduct 4D simulations to understand project phasing and construction sequencing, taking the project one step closer to the field.
Okay, Yanale presented the menu. I have completed my presentation. So I was just trying to explain what are the different softwares included and what are the total, you know, picture of the course. And you are learning the module one we cover in that, you know, all the products for developing, you know, BIM concepts and fundamentals, Formic for conceptual design, and Revit for architectural design. So these are the first module content in that. So I think I conveyed my topics here, my syllabus, all the details of the link. Any questions you can ask me.
Hello, Viju, there is a question.
Yeah.
Student has raised a concern of, with the system specification. Is I5 enough for BIM?
I5 is enough. I5 is good. More than I5 or I3 will work, but the problem is graphics card is the concern here. Graphics card, because most of the computers come in with a low configured graphics card. So if you're buying a new one, always go for a gaming laptop. That's an excellent graphics card. You know, comes with the gaming laptops. And nowadays, you know, there are a lot of special offers going on from Flipkart and Amazon. That gives you very attractive pricing. And memory, 8 GB is minimum. 16 GB is better. So if you have a computer, already having a computer with the i5, 8 GB, this will do. Course can be learned. But if you are buying a new one, always invest a good one with the graphics card, with a good graphics card. All the normal computers are giving with the graphics are internal. So you need a good graphics chip card for that. I think I answered the question. Any other question?
No other questions. So I think it's we can wind up the session now.
Yeah.
No other questions. One second. Okay. Thank you, Viju Anthony, for explaining the details of the course.
Okay.
ASAP Kerala provided in the Autodesk BIM for architect design development and the course in the details. A course in a registry and a link chat in share either. So you can make use of the link. And also you can log on to asapkerala.gov.in for details. Adwaltana Namada is session day or lingal end the queries on Dangalum chat. ഷെയർ ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്ന ട്രെയിനിങ് അണ്ടർസ്കോൾ ടെക് അറ്റ് അസാപ് കേരള ഡോട്ട് ജി ഒ വി ഡോട്ട് ഇൻ എന്ന സൈറ്റിൽ എന്ന മെയിലിലേക്ക് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നിങ്ങളുടെ ക്വയറീസ് ഷെയർ ചെയ്യാവുന്നതാണ്. സോ ഐ തിങ്ക് വി ക്യാൻ വൈൻഡ് അപ്പ് ദ സെഷൻ. സോ വൺസ് അഗൈൻ ലെറ്റ് മീ താങ്ക് വിജു ആന്റണി ആൻഡ് അഖില കെ മുരളി ടു ടേക്കിംഗ് ദിസ് സെഷൻ ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഐ എം താങ്കിങ് ഓൾ ദ പാർട്ടിസിപ്പൻസ് ഹു അറ്റൻഡഡ് ദ സെഷൻ. താങ്ക് യു.